Max Planck is one of the most important scientists who came up with ideas that gave birth to our modern physics. He won the Nobel Prize in 1918. In this class, we will be learning about the idea that made him win that Nobel Prize. This is exquisite, and you are welcome to the class.
Wow, I'm excited to learn what this is about.
His idea about light is very simple, although not very obvious at first. He explained that light comes in packets, and he referred to these packets as photons.
Oh. Photons mean light packets?
Yes, and each packet carries an amount of energy that depends on the frequency.
Okay.
Light of high frequency is therefore made up of photons that carry so much energy.
And if the light frequency is lower, then it is made up of photons that have less energy.
Exactly. Mathematically, he was therefore saying that the energy of a wave is directly proportional to its frequency.
Oh, I remember. In mathematics, we can write that statement as E directly proportional to F, where E is energy, and F is frequency.
That's correct, Titi.
And then, we can usually turn the proportionality sign into an equality sign, and introduce a constant, K.
That's also correct. However, in physics, we use letter H, instead of letter K, to represent the constant.
Oh. Why is that, Sensei?
Nothing so interesting, Titi. It was the same letter that Planck used while he was explaining his idea. It came from a German word, Hilfsgross, which means an auxiliary quantity.
Okay. Max Planck was German?
Yes, and since it doesn't matter which letter of the alphabet is used in science, scientists have decided to continually use the letter H. And in fact, that constant has been named after Max Planck. We call it the Planck's constant.
That's kind and beautiful.
Planck also found out that the value of this constant is about 6.6 times 10 raised to power minus 34 joule seconds.
I see. This appears to explain why high-frequency light is usually able to eject electrons from metal surfaces.
Yes, high-frequency light carries high-energy photons, and when such photons strike a metal surface, they usually can dislodge electrons from the metal surface.
Photoelectricity is clearer to me now. If the photon energy is greater than or equal to the work function of a metal, then the photon can dislodge electrons from that metal.
Correct. The work function is the energy that binds the electrons to the metal, and so if a photon of greater energy strikes the metal surface, it will knock electrons off the surface.
Okay.
Observe that, since Planck's equation connects energy and frequency, we can also talk of the work function in terms of frequency.
Okay. E is equal to HF.
Yes, we can replace E with W, which is the work function, or energy that holds the electrons to the metal.
And then we replace F with F0, which is the corresponding amount of frequency that holds the electrons to the metal.
Ha, that's an interesting way to look at it. And that is correct. So we get a new equation, W equals HF0, where F0 is an amount of frequency, known as the threshold frequency.
So, we can define the threshold frequency of a metal as the smallest frequency that must be possessed by a photon before it can eject electrons from the metal surface.
Perfect. If we like, we can also talk about the work function in terms of wavelength.
Yes, I remember that frequency and wavelength are related by the formula F equals C over lambda, where C is speed of light, and lambda is the wavelength.
Correct. So, if we replace the F in that equation with F0, we should also replace lambda with lambda0.
And we have F0 equals C over lambda0.
Correct. Lambda0 is similarly called the threshold wavelength. In our equation of the work function, we can replace F0 with C over lambda0.
And that gives W equals HC over lambda naught.
Great. Since H and C are constants, You can see that work function and lambda are inversely related.
That's true. Energy and wavelength are inversely related. Long wavelengths mean small energies, while short wavelengths mean large energies.
That's right. The wavelength should therefore be short, so that the wave can have enough energy to eject electrons from a metal surface.
Okay. If the wavelength exceeds a certain amount, then the photon energy will not be enough to eject electrons from the metal surface.
Yes. The threshold wavelength is therefore the maximum wavelength which the photon must possess so as to be able to eject electrons from the metal surface.
I get it. For photoelectricity to take place, the photon energy or frequency must be greater than the work function or threshold frequency. But the photon wavelength must be smaller than the threshold wavelength.
Perfect summary. Now give us a summary of the entire class before we leave.
1. Light is made up of energy packets, known as photons. 2. E equals HF. So, light of high frequency contains high energy photons. 3. The threshold frequency of a metal is the minimum frequency of photons that can eject electrons from the metal surface. And finally, the threshold wavelength is the maximum wavelength of photons that can eject electrons from the metal surface.
Great. See you in the next class, where we will be learning about a very important equation, known as the Einstein's photoelectric equation.
Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our videos. Thank you.